Ladies and gentlemen, one half of the U.S. Tag Champions, the Sultan of Swing, Beautiful Bobby!
Mr. Cornette has already introduced the challenger. Now, it's my pleasure to introduce to you the U.S. Heavyweight Champion from Austin, Texas, weighing in at 285 pounds, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
We'll be right back.
Tell you, it's already started.
Oh, he blows the kiss.
We talk a lot about psychological warfare in this sport, and there's a lot being inflicted right now, Jim Cornette, and the master is Dusty Rhodes.
That's true, but Tony, look at these fans, oh, they love it.
What do you think that envelope will have to do in this match? You think maybe Dusty's thinking about that and it'll interfere in the match?
Well, I think, you know, a picture says a thousand words. You know, announcers can talk and talk and talk and talk and talk, but nothing like a facial expression like we saw when Dusty Rhodes opened the envelope.
Bob, do it. Right to the post. Dusty takes him. Oh. Concrete floor. It doesn't give an inch.
Time to go after Dusty Rhodes. He's become the bunkhouse champion once again. He's got to be sky high right now, and he's always been one of the greatest wrestlers in the world. The last man on earth I'd want to get in a ring with would be Dusty Rhodes right now at this time in history, because Beautiful Bobby may not have a prayer.
Tony, this is a dream match. Think about it. This is for the United States heavyweight title. The champion Dusty Rhodes, Jim Cornette. Beautiful Bobby is one half of the United States Tag Team Champions. Cornette has set his sights on Dusty. They want to defeat him. They want to put him out.
And what a gala evening this is with Ric Flair and the award ceremony set up here in the Dorton Arena in Raleigh, North Carolina. Jim Ross over there right now. I know they're putting the final touches on everything. It's just a big program here today. And we have a lot more to come, because Dusty Rhodes right now is taking care of business in the ring.
Left again, comes up.
Nobody does it better.
That time, Beautiful Bobby kind of stumbled backwards, and he hit the rope, sprang right into Dusty Rhodes' bionic elbow.
Coming up.
The elbow comes down on the knee.
You know, for many weeks we have been hearing from Jim Cornette, from the Midnight Express, about what they're going to do to Dusty Rhodes, about how beautiful Bobby's going to take the U.S. heavyweight title. He's got his chance right here today, plus national television and his chance.
Plus, Cornette also got the contract the way he wanted it. Remember, he helped Bobby out until he got it.
It's psychological warfare. We talked about it.
Cornette now. You saw it. Distracted the referee. Uses that tennis racket. Dusty's down. They see him right there. Here comes Bobby.
That leg has been broken. That knee has been twisted. When you go through all the years Dusty Rhodes has been in the ring, you got your share of injuries, and Jim Cornette knows all about them. Beautiful Bobby knows all about them. They'll try to go at those weak points and take advantage of Dusty Rhodes. But Carlos Cornette said he wants to put Dusty out of wrestling as much as win the U.S. heavyweight title.
He's got the chair.
We do have to take a break, fans. This is for the U.S. heavyweight title. We still have the Ric Flair ceremony to go and much more. Don't you dare go away.
They've been working on that leg the whole time. Bobby comes back with that tennis racket.
They have been working on it with that one main weapon, the tennis racket. Cornette jumps up on the apron of the ring. He slips Bobby the racket. It goes right to the knee. They've done it three times now.
United States heavyweight title. Remember, it's on the line. Bobby stays with it. Dusty's out.
Racket in the world, and Cornette scared to death right now.
Look out, Bobby.
Dusty did the right thing that time. He got right into the ring. Watch, beautiful Bobby went to the back of the knee.
Do whatever you take your own, the ball.
Both men are hurting.
That's right. He's right. You're inside. My face. It's on the Cornette.
Well, he went face first right to that concrete. Still, though, relentless pressure by beautiful Bobby. He nailed him right there, David. Slapped the taste right out of his mouth. Blocked it.
I can't do it. Remember the leg. Remember the leg. It came on him. You see it?
But still, the effects of that suplex were felt.
The timing's off. Now his timing's off.
That's right. Any great athlete will tell you once your timing gets off, once you start to hurt sometimes, only thing you think about is pain. And beautiful Bobby's going to make sure that's all he's thinking about right now.
All right, Bobby's hurting too because right now he's content to hold the
remain.
We are at the 20-minute mark to go. 10 minutes have expired in this 30-minute time limit. And Dusty Rhodes is trying to hold on right here. Now, Cornette right in his face.
Bobby, if he was at full speed, he would be working a lot harder to take that knee out.
Well, Bobby was doing two things right there. Number one, working on the knee, but also giving himself a breather.
Goes right for the face. Ripping at the eyes. Dusty turns him around. Goes up. Again, what about... Throws it out of the corner. Dusty gets ready. Comes up. Jump kick.
That was perfectly timed because Beautiful Bobby is so quick. Dusty got the upper hand. Oh, they hit heads that time, David, and they both went down very hard. See any of those things again. You know, as Dusty Rhodes walks away, still the U.S. champion, I understand Ric Flair is nearing the building. We'll be going to Jim Ross in just a second.
The gentleman, like Tony said, Ric Flair is on his way to the building. Dusty Rhodes was disqualified for an object that you brought into the ring.
Get my tail belt.
It's not yours. You didn't.
Let me tell you something right now. I'm going to tell you something, Dusty. Where were you, boys? He hit me. I could have chipped. My mother spent a lot of money on my dentist when I was a kid, so I'd have perfect teeth, David Crockett. You understand what I'm saying? Don't you smirk at me. Now, let me tell you something, Dusty Rhodes, and I want you to listen real good. Nobody puts their hands on Jim Cornette, brother. I don't care whether I got to go to the ends of the earth, spend every penny that my mama has in the bank and everything she's got stashed around the house. If I got to go out to a sporting goods store and get a bone air, I swear by God above that you're going to pay for what you did. You are going to pay to Beautiful Bobby. You're going to pay to Stanley. You're going to pay to Dick Murdoch. And most of all, you are going to pay to Jim Cornette. Dusty Rhodes, I will see not only the end of your career, but the end of your life before I have a stroke, before I have a heart attack. The only other thing I got to say before I go back here and get an ice pack for my face is that Jimmy Crockett, you little crook, you little tight pocket, you little weasel that's always trying to cheat us. Jimmy Crockett, I want a match with Dusty Rhodes and Beautiful Bobby next week here on TV, and I'm going to get it because everybody's trying to cheat us, including you, Jimmy Crockett.